Once you've logged into the employer portal, you'll be taken to your organization's dashboard, where you'll have a pending return. To upload worker details, you import their details using an Excel spreadsheet. It's worthwhile looking at the instructions for completing a return spreadsheet. The spreadsheet requires you to submit work, employment, worker, and gender type codes. You can find these in the instructions. With the exception of the codes, you'll be able to copy and paste data from your own records into the spreadsheet. The member ID will be blank because this will be a new worker. The start date needs to be the 1st of July, unless they commenced work after that date. You can enter your hours and period pay here. After saving the spreadsheet, you can upload it back into the system. You can review your return here, and if you wish to put long service leave against an employer, you can simply edit the return and indicate that long service leave was taken in the period. You can now submit the return. On the returns page, you will now see your invoice along with payment details. For any questions, our customer service and education team is here to help and can be contacted by phone or email.